I will extol thee, my God, O King, and I will bless thy name forever and ever. Every day will I bless thee, and I will praise thy name forever and ever.
Praise the Lord, and great is your praise, and great is your service.
One generation shall praise thy works to another, and shall declare thy mighty acts. I will speak of the glorious honor of thy majesty, and of thy wondrous works.
Thank you. whatever you're seeking from the Lord, put it on your mind, get it in your heart, get it in your spirit. Then give your faith to the Lord at this time. Gracious Father, in the most holy and precious name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Thanking you for your goodness, for your mercy, for your grace, for your long-suffering, for your kindness. Hallelujah. Thank you for your ever presence. Thank you for being in our midst, even on this morning, for allowing us to be here, that we may give glory to your name. We thank you for our pastor, for his influence with the church. We thank you for allowing him to be in this service one day. Thank you for the ministry of this church. Thank you for every member of this church. Thank you for those who visited with us this morning. We ask you to bring inspiration, hallelujah, and the anointing of the Lord, even in our midst of today. Bless those who stand for this altar, whatever the needs are. Father, I pray that they might cast it upon you, knowing that you're able to do exceeding abundantly above all we ask of your name. And there are those standing, hallelujah, in the audience that need your help. They may be discouraged, they may be despondent, or read whatever the circumstances are, Lord, we know you're able. And then we ask you to reach out beyond these four walls and touch them, heal them, and deliver as necessary that they might power of your own shed blood. Bless your priest's word this morning. The word of God is already blessed, so we ask you to bless our hearts that we might be receptive and open to your word. So the soul might be saved today. Somebody might be encouraged today. Hallelujah. Somebody might give their will over to the will of the Lord. So that I might serve you in the holy. Father, we ask all these things for the assurance that you will do them according to your divine will, according to your pleasure. Whatever way you bless us, Lord, however you bless us, when you bless us, Lord, we glorify your name. We count these things as done in the precious name of Jesus. We give your name glory now and forever. Hallelujah. There's still another praise. There's still another hallelujah. There's still another glory of God. There's still another praise in the name of Jesus left in us today. Give your name glory out and praise. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen, amen, amen.
Scripture lesson on this morning will come to us from the book of Galatians, 6th chapter.
Amen.
Galatians 6th chapter. We read verses 7 through 9. And it reads as follows. Be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap.
Amen.
For he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption.
Amen.
But he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting.
Amen.
And let us not be weary in well-doing.
Amen.
For in due season, we shall reap.
Amen.
If we faint not.
Amen.
Let the church shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank and praise God for his word and the reading and hearing of this word. We know that you will be edified in your hearts.
Amen.
This time we come to a part of our service where we all anticipate that is in the giving of our tithe and our offering. Our part is going to come forth to sing one verse of our consecration and our faith. Let us be, after which the deacons and ushers will take charge of this part of the service.
I thank God through you.
members of this church are so happy to have you here with us today. We invite you and encourage you to join in with us as we praise and worship this great God of our salvation together. We want you to know that you're always welcome here at Christian Church. May God bless you. You may be seated.
Thank you.
such a good heart. You're always saying something thoughtful or doing something kind. And today, I want to be sure you know how very much you appreciate it. With love, Angela Haight and family. Prayer is requested for Sister Alden Kiner, who we have serving on tomorrow. Prayer is also requested for Ms. Kathy Brown, Jane Brown, and Christian Newell. Continue to pray for all of those who are on the prayer list. Others who are special requests on the altar and the bereaved families. Remember to pray for our pastor, Bishop Edward Smith, our pastors, elders, ministers, deacons, and all saints everywhere. This concludes our announcements. Thank you.
Bless her with many more years to be with us.
Amen.
for Jesus. He's such a wonderful Savior. Never known a fail. But can you ever set that on Jesus Christ? I know Jesus brought me all the way.
be like, sometimes you got depressed when you don't feel like it. The song goes, the depressed song is so depressed. So again, we thank God for such pain to them. Faithful servant of the Lord.
Amen.
study the history of the verb, a consonant is a sequence or a certain set of circumstances that follows one's choice or action. Consonants can be positive or negative.
Amen.
We read in our scripture text, Galatians, scripture text 6, be not deceived, God is not mocked. Most of us, as soon as you read that, you think about something negative. But it goes both ways. He says, be not deceived, God is not mocked, whatsoever man soweth, that shall he reap. That's great.
Amen.
Now, if you sow the wrong thing, you're going to reap the wrong thing.
Amen.
But if you sow the right thing, you're going to reap the right thing. He said, if you sow the bad, other than that, you're going to reap corruption.
Amen.
But if you sow to the Spirit, you shall reap life everlasting.
Amen.
So, the consequent base is based upon that. If you do positive things inside of God, you get positive
results.
On the other hand, if you do negative things, you get negative results. But we live in this time of all these different doctrines of one kind, the doctrine of inclusion that says everybody, whether you accept the Lord Jesus Christ or not, everybody is just going to be saved. Some churches call it wider verses, as if the verse of God is already wide. Bible says he gives us new verses every month. God doesn't have to make this verse alive. Man, if God's verse was alive, it won't take me in. It'll buy me
nothing.
Don't y'all sit there looking at me body. If God's verse was alive, it won't take you in. It'll buy me nothing. You don't need a lot of verses. You just need the verse of God.
Amen.
And to obey God in all we do.
Amen.
I'm reading the book of Ezekiel. Three times in the book, the people of God said to God, you are unequal. Another word for that would be, you're unfair. Can you imagine him that is standing in the face of God and saying to God, oh, you're not fair? The thing about it is that God treated us the way we deserve to be treated, to be fair. You never praise God for mercy.
Amen.
That's all he needs is to tell you that that's not the choice, but
yield your member as a sense of righteousness, then you get a righteous reward.
Amen.
Everyone has a will, everyone has a choice.
Amen.
Now, the Bible tells us in the book of Deuteronomy 28, the Lord says he showed us showing how the consequence is based on your choice. The Lord said, if you walk the right road, I bless you in the city, I bless you in the field, I bless your animals, I bless you, I bless your body. But he turns around and says, but if you don't, I'll curse you in the city, I'll curse you in the field, I'll curse your animals, I'll curse your cow, I'll curse your body. All of this depends upon our land.
Amen.
And I want to read something that's decided to read a little bit for me from 2 Corinthians chapter 7. But I want to put it on the screen. Beginning with verse 12. 2 Chronicles. Chapter 7.
Amen.
What does he say?
And the Lord appeared to Solomon, and I had said unto him, I have heard thy prayer, and have chosen this place to myself for the house of sacrifice.
Now let me see if I can set the answers here. They were about to dedicate the temple, what we call Solomon's temple. This was the greatest temple that existed in the land. And I'll be honest with you, I think that people wanted a temple so that the children of God could come into the wilderness, they had a tent. They put it up, and they took it out, and they moved it. It becomes torn and tattered and worn. And they says to the Lord, Lord, my house is dead. The way I live is better than where you were. I want to build you a house.
Amen.
Well, that's admirable, David. But what house are you going to build? The earth. Hallelujah, my first school. Heaven, my mom, you're going to build a house. He said, but I tell you what, I'll let your son build it, and I will put my name in it.
Amen.
So as you Solomon prayed this exhaustive prayer. And then he just prayed, he went through a whole lot of contingency. Lord, if this happens, that happens, then what? And then he said to the Lord, my Lord, I know we often have sin, and if you ever get carried away out of my land, he would just say that day, look toward Jerusalem, look toward the temple, you can hear them pray. And so after Solomon prayed this exhaustive prayer, when he finally came to him, the Lord did to him. The Lord did Solomon, and I said to him, I have heard that prayer and have chosen this place to myself for a house of sacrifice. Verse 13.
If I shut up heaven, that there be no
rain. Now this is what I'm saying. If I shut up heaven, that there be no rain.
Where my hand belongs to devour the land.
Mm-hmm.
Where my sin the pestilence among my people.
Mm-hmm.
If my people. Go and serve other gods and worship them.
Yeah, what will I do?
Then
What does that used to be? The Lord is saying, what is your choice? You're not there. That's why he said God is not wrong. You're not going to be able to sneer at God because of what happens to you. You're going to be a choice. You tell them, therefore you will die. You choose my life, you will live. So God says, I put this house, I let you build this house. But I tell you what, if you don't serve me, if you take my house and bring the idols in and start praising or praising the idols, I will talk to you about the root out of this land and have it happen. The Jews were dispersed all over the world. God let me disturb and took that house and that house went in ruins for many years. And even when they rebuilt it, the glory of the land. God said, I'll give you a border, but it never had your people. And therefore, when the old folks saw it, they didn't wait till the whole thing finished. The Bible said, when they laid the foundation of the new temple, the old folks started crying because they remembered the former temple. Now, the young folks were excited because they had never seen Solomon's temple. But I want to tell us today, there are consequences of our choice. All right, thank you. Joshua 24, our last stop to turn here on. Joshua 24.
Amen.
Joshua died at 110 years old. And God turned into the promised land. He had seen the past age. Sometimes they served the Lord, sometimes they didn't. Sometimes they did close their eyes, sometimes they didn't. And Joshua was getting close to death. And he called all of them together and he began to repent, to recount that to them. All of the things that I've done. He said, now listen, don't y'all remember how he gave you houses that you didn't build? God gave you wells that you didn't dig.
Amen.
God gave you vineyards that you didn't plant. And he said, sometimes you know what you're saying, that God didn't put you in the fight. God just sent the hornets, the bees. Y'all know how we run the bees, don't you? He brought out nations with hornets. And then he's going to turn and not serve the Lord.
Come on, Lord.
He did not like to say something. He
didn't
serve God.
Amen.
Because God has been good enough for each one of us individually for us to serve the Lord.
Amen.
He no longer talk about how God brought them out of Egypt and after having all of the struggle. Hallelujah. But God brought you all the way back to Abraham and talk about how God called Abraham out. Serving the idol of God, but God called him out because God needed him to be at a place that he could bless. And he said, now, I want you, as I'm going down on my day, I want you to remember what God is doing.
Amen.
Can't you see what the Lord is doing? Amen. Can't you glorify his name for what God is doing? Amen. And you know how I like to tell people who want to forget God, you don't need him again.
Amen.
You know how people are so mad to get up and sweep you up and get up. But if God still loves the world,
yeah.
God of love and another God of compassion and man, all that is wrapped up in my woman. Oh, he's about to have him and kill him, but he got a woman's own child. He said, oh, God up in heaven, I don't need to know all of these God. All I need to do is call on the name of Jesus. Because he has all powers. So he says, if there's anyone you go ahead and serve those gods with your father serve, that will want us out of the blood of God's man.
In whose land we dwell, mm-hmm. But as for me and my house, mm-hmm. We will serve the Lord.
I'm not saying
you start preparing for retirement. You're 21 years old, sister, man. I got 39. Those years will roll around so fast, it seems like a bat in your mind.
Put a ribbon on it and go right back.